Given our raging addiction to smartphones, how hard could it be to sell a company that actually makes them? Pretty hard. Hello and welcome to The Deal Report. I'm Jeff Kanige. Once upon a time, it seemed like almost everyone had a BlackBerry or wanted one. It was a miracle device, conferring status and coolness on its users, also email. Then, in the flick of a rollerball, it was over. Now, it would be hard to find someone who will admit to owning one of those infernal machines. And that's a big problem for BlackBerry's board as it tries to sell the company. BlackBerry's decline is well documented. Its gadgets now struggle for market share against Google's Android phones, Apple's iPhones, and whatever it is Microsoft is peddling these days. Now, a couple of potential buyers have come forward, Lenovo for one. China-based PC maker sees smartphones as small computers, and BlackBerry might be a natural fit. But a sale to Lenovo would put one of the most prominent Canadian businesses in foreign hands, and some Canadians want to prevent that. Bram Watsa for one. He runs Fairfax Financial, one of BlackBerry's biggest shareholders. Watsa also served on BlackBerry's board, a seat he relinquished when the company put itself up for sale. Watsa is trying to arrange a buyout and keep the company and its thousands of jobs in Canada. Any buyer, though, has to deal with a couple of inconvenient facts. First is BlackBerry's small and shrinking market share. Investors might not be enthusiastic about backing a company that seems to be dying. The second problem was actually thought to be one of BlackBerry's strengths, its patents. The conventional wisdom held that even if the company couldn't sell many gadgets, at least it had a pile of attractive intellectual property. A string of big-money patent deals by Nortel Networks, AOL, and Kodak made that view seem reasonable. Turns out, though, that BlackBerry's patents may not be worth that much. As the deal's Paula Schapp reports, most potential buyers pretty much have what they need at this point. They made all those big-money deals, after all. And those deals haven't quite planned out the way the buyers had hoped. So how hard is it to sell BlackBerry? Just as hard as it is to sell a BlackBerry. In New York, this is Jeff Kanige for The Deal.